we're testing is whether or not we could use a fire extinguisher like in the movie Gravity, where Sandra Bullock's character uses a fire extinguisher.
10, 3.
To redirection herself.
2.
And propel herself in space.
1. Ah. I'm coming, Eliza! I'm coming! Stay there!
Clearly, our budding space cadet had next to no directional control.
I just obliterated the finish line.
It was beautiful.
From the inside, all I saw was just, like, mist around me, and then I see, like, a pole.
But it was Elijah's first ever time firing a fire extinguisher. His failure may have been operational inexperience rather than experimental. So, he's getting another chance.
Obstacle course fire extinguisher test in 3, 2, 1.
It's almost working.
Oh, no.
Go hit it.
Dude. That was perfect. We actually saw you steering yourself with the fire extinguisher, and it looked like it worked.
I managed to not knock over the finish line this time.
That's a huge bonus, because you were about to. You saw it at the last second, adjusted your direction, and managed not to knock it over, and you were almost going to. Look, for the first part of the test, it was ambiguous whether Elijah was shifting his direction or whether he was just pushing the obstacles out of the way. But in the finish line, it was totally unambiguous. He was heading towards the right-hand goalpost, he gave a blast in that direction, and made himself go cleanly through without hitting anything. That's what I call a successful test.
A successful test requires a repeatable result.
You've achieved some balance with the force.
Jesse's up next.
Hovercraft obstacle course test in 3, 2, 1. He's hitting all the obstacles. Uh-oh.
It was a lot harder than what it looks.
You hit everything.
Yeah, I know. You can pretty much say that I destroyed the solar system.
Jesse's test was not nearly as successful as Elijah's. He did hit, I think, every single planet on his way. However, it was clear he was changing his direction with the fire extinguisher. It's just that it was happening at a much slower rate than it seems to happen in the movie. So the fire extinguisher has to overcome a ton of inertia, which means every reaction is much slower than each of the people testing expects it to be.
All right, Valerie, in 3, 2, 1.
Yep, and a similar result for Valerie seals the deal. All signs point to the fire extinguisher lacking enough thrust to overcome and control the momentum of our astronauts in the same way it did in the movie.
All right, guys, we have gathered all the evidence I think we can. How do you want to call this myth?
I want to call this myth busted, and for 3 reasons. Unlike the movie, we couldn't reverse direction, we were barely able to steer, and we couldn't gain control when we were spinning out of control.
All right, I think you're totally right. It's completely busted. Busted?
Busted.
Busted?
Busted.
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 Okay, 3, 2, 1,
busted.